Hi there, it's Eitan from Vimy. We are facing a major transition from a 10 billion devices world to 1 trillion devices world. And this has a major impact of networks today, which requires new breed of architecture and actually using the edge of the network to process all these compute, storage, and requests from end users. So now we are in transition from the big data era to the distributed edge era. So the idea is actually to move all the virtualization and the compute and the processing engines from central location to the edge of the networks. And when we speak about edge of networks, we also refer to mobile network, fixed networks, Wi-Fi networks, cable network, internet service provider networks, any type of networks that can actually serve demands from end users. So the motivation of moving the resources to the edge are many, right? So the telcos today and in their plans of growth for the future, they want to use their infrastructure to provide more and more unique value services to their users. Those services can be on the B2C level, but they can also be on the B2B level. So for example, managing autonomous car fleets, introducing VR and AR for gaming and for live streaming, all the issues of public safety and managing all the video cameras in smart cities, variety of issues around tourism, location-based advertising, video over the top. All these new revenue generators require new type of infrastructure and network that MEC is actually resolving. Specifically for mobile operators, we need to discuss about the era of 4G versus the era of 5G. Because in 4G, those virtualization resources, all the servers and the compute resources are actually not there. The network is characterized by the use of eNodeBs or base station to process traffic, to manage the billing session, and the management of all the user calls. But in the 5G era, those eNodeBs will be completely virtualized, and the eNodeB itself will be able to cater more and more third-party application, like providing variety of services, as I described before. Now, why do we need edge computing, right? So one is the use of the edge of the network to process huge amount of data, but also to process it at a very, very low latency. Now, today, the latencies around the world for processing the user data are around hundreds of milliseconds. Edge computing, and specifically MEC, discusses single-digit millisecond end-to-end latency or round-trip time to serve users. Now, this is much below the radio latency itself, so any request from users can be a request for video or request for data or updating status and geolocation, variety of application will be processed in less than 10 milliseconds from the edge. And this is a really, really huge breakthrough that only the telcos can provide. So MEC is actually happening right now. It is being pushed by the telcos, but also by Google, Facebook, Apple, and Amazon. Each one of those companies has their own initiative for MEC. So with Google, they are deploying the YouTube servers at the edge of the telco infrastructure. With Facebook, they are promoting TIP, which is a telecom infra project initiative that is all about virtualizing the edge and processing all the video and VR at the edge of the network. Amazon, they are deploying Greengrass application at the edge of the telco. So out of 300 AWS different applications, 70,000 applications are actually going to be served from the edge. They call them Greengrass, and it's actually the way to manage IoT and processing at the edge of the network. Thank you very much for listening. Please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channels and register to our newsletters. See you soon. Thank you and bye-bye.